Hi and welcome to a new Quick Edit video. This time I want to create another composite image, which means I'm going to use that shot and I'm replacing the sky with another picture from the Milky Way. So before I go on with the editing, first let's check out the before and after images. Okay, and before I start the compositing, I'm going through Lightroom real quick. First, I'm activating the lens correction settings, then I'm going back to the top. I'm changing the profile to Adobe Landscape. This will add some slight saturation to the image and also it will boost the shadows a little bit. Then I want to work on the white balance, and because I'm going to replace the sky with a nighttime sky, I want to make the image colder. That means I'm decreasing the temperature a little bit. Also, I want to work on the global settings. For this shot, I'm decreasing the highlights first. And I want to try to get a clear edge on the horizon, so I will later have an easier time replacing the sky in Photoshop. Also, I want to boost the shadows. And to add some contrast, right away, I'm decreasing the blacks a little bit. Also, I'm going to add clarity. And again, because this is going to be a nighttime shot, I want to desaturate it a bit by reducing the vibrance. Also, I want to apply a little bit of split toning. That means I'm going to choose a cold color for the shadows. Somewhere in this range seems to be good. And I'm not touching the highlights, but I want to sharpen the image. That is it for the Lightroom part for now, so I'm going to open the image in Photoshop. Okay, then let's start with the most annoying part, at least for me, that's creating the selection for the sky to later replace it. And I'm going to use the TK panel for that, which will help me create luminosity masks by pressing this button right here. Now I'm switching from the Layers tab to the Channels tab, and you can see all those lights layers which the TK panel just created. And here I'm just looking for the channel which separates all the foreground stuff I want to keep from the sky I want to replace later. And in this case, I think I'm going with the lights 2 channels, which I'm just duplicating. Now to further separate sky and foreground, which means all the stuff I want to keep will be black and the sky needs to be white for that. I'm going to play around with the levels on that layer by pressing Ctrl L. And now I'm going to drag the white point a little bit to the left. And here the center point a little bit to the right. I'm paying close attention to the edge on the horizon, so the sky and the landscape doesn't blend together. This would cause some problems. Okay, then to further adjust that layer, I'm selecting the brush tool by pressing B. And set the blending mode of the brush to overlay and the opacity to 100%. And of course the foreground color is set to white now. And what's happening when I'm brushing in there, only the brighter areas will be affected by the brush because I set the blending mode to overlay. And then I'm just trying to separate foreground and the sky as good as possible. Now in this area it might be not possible at all, but maybe I'm going to crop it out later, I don't know yet. So here comes another tricky area on the edge of the landscape. Now I can just switch the foreground color to black and paint over the landscape, and as you can see only the dark areas will be affected by the black color. And we get this nice edge. Then I'm switching back to white again. And I will repeat this until I have a nice edge. Okay, and now that I'm satisfied with the separation, I'm going to select that lights 2 copy layer by pressing Ctrl and clicking on that thumbnail. And I'm going back to the Layers tab. And I want to further modify the selection just a little bit. First, I'm expanding it by 1 pixel, and I'm also going to smooth it by 1 pixel. And now I'm clicking on the layer mask icon, and reverse the DMS by pressing Ctrl-I. Okay, you can already see the foreground is kind of transparent, but that's not a problem. I'm going to fix that by brushing over there with a white brush. And it's time to place a new sky in there. I'm going to use an image from unsplash.com, which I'm going to link in the description. Let's make it a bit bigger. Okay, and of course I need to place it behind that foreground layer. Now there are still some leftovers from the old sky, so I need to mask them out again. Again, I'm setting the brush mode to overlay and I just select the layer mask and I'm setting the foreground color to black. And this way I can fix all those ugly spots there. Okay, and also I want to adjust the brightness of the foreground because right now it really doesn't fit. So I'm applying a brightness adjustment layer and just decrease the brightness quite a bit. Also, of course, I need to clip it to the foreground. That means I'm holding the Alt key down and click between those two layers. It's already starting to look quite realistic. So next, I think I want to already crop the image a bit. I think this way it looks quite nice. I can also scale up the background a bit further. Now, of course, I also need to fill the gaps in the background. First, I'm duplicating the background layer and then I'm flipping it horizontally. And now I just drag it over to the left side. And I'm grabbing the clone stamp tool and I want to copy an area from here down there. And I'm doing the same thing for the right side, so duplicating the layer and flipping it horizontally. And then I'm just dragging it all the way to the right. Again, I'm merging those two and I'm grabbing the clone stamp tool, get rid of this thing and make the bottom area a bit darker. Alright, I think that looks quite nice. Maybe I can even go darker with the foreground. I think that looks actually better. And let's fix this small spot. Now, of course, I want to have some focus on the castle in the middle of the image. That means I'm going to work on the brightness adjustment layer a little bit more. I'm just using the brush with the black foreground color and set the opacity of the brush to around 20%. And then I can brighten up this area a little bit more. That's way, way, way too much. So I'm going to reverse that. Let's set the opacity of the brush to 10%. So next, there's another problem I want to fix, because you never will be able to see the stars that close to the edge of the landscape. So I need to brighten it up just above the edge. And first, therefore, I'm applying a new layer and set the blending mode to soft light. And I just place the new layer above the Milky Way image. Next, I'm again picking the brush tool and I want to brush just over the horizon. And so it starts to look more realistic, but I'm still not satisfied. So what I can also do is to apply another brightness adjustment layer above the Milky Way and increase the brightness quite a bit. And then I'm filling the layer mask of that adjustment layer with black and with the white color and maybe even the lower opacity of the brush, I can brush in that layer mask. And of course, this glow will also affect the foreground. So I'm going to apply a new layer on top of every other layer. And then I'm just brushing in a few times, just so the glow is overlapping the lens. And you can see I don't even need to change the blending mode of this one. So next, I think I want to mask out some of that foreground glow, just because the castle is affected. So I'm masking out a bit of that castle. Let's apply some more glow to the stars of the Milky Way. Again, I'm applying a new layer, but this time I'm setting the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm choosing a slight blue color tone, but still very bright. Okay. Also, I'm setting the brush opacity to 10% this time. And I'm starting with a 1 pixel brush. And to apply this glow effect, I'm going to increase the brush size as I brush in. And this is what I will be doing for a few of those brighter stars. Next, I want to get rid of this ugly table in the foreground. I think I first want to try get rid of it by using the spot healing brush. Let's see if this works. Okay, I'm quite surprised it did work that well. Still on the ground, there's some messy stuff going on, so I'm just using the clone stamp for this one. Maybe I should adjust the glow over the horizon a little bit more, because I think it might be too bright actually. So I just decrease the opacity a bit. Also, I could add some more contrast by using a curves adjustment layer and just create a simple S-curve for this. Okay, I also don't want to overdo the editing for this one. I am already quite satisfied with the result, so that's it for editing this image. Then let's do a small recap of the editing. So there were a few Lightroom adjustments, like changing the profile to add some more saturation and increase the shadows. I decreased the temperature of the white balance to make the image a little colder, which fits the nightly theme of the image quite nice. I reduced the highlights a bit, which helped me replace the sky more easily. I also increased the shadows and decreased the blacks to add some contrast. Then I've added some clarity and reduced the vibrance, again because this was going to be a nighttime shot. And I have applied slight split toning to apply a cold color to the shadow areas, and of course the sharpening. After which I switched over to Photoshop again. And here I have cut out the sky part of the image, replaced it with the new Milky Way sky. Then I have adjusted the foreground brightness a bit. I also added some glow to the horizon of the image to make it look more natural. And I have also added some glow to some of those brighter stars in the sky. And finally, a curve to add some more contrast. So I hope this was a nice and interesting composite image editing video. And of course, if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching this video.